Praise the Lord. Good to have each and every one of you in the house of the Lord. Thank God for our Facebook family, YouTube family. Amen. Give the Lord and Brother Michael a great big hand as he comes. Amen. Give a shout out to the Lord. Amen. Give him a sit down. Amen.
Yes, and it's even Allison. Well, I have a prayer of grace to thanks on this morning. What a beautiful day for the Lord to come in.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but I want to see Jesus.
Amen.
I love it when I feel him, and I know he's with me always, but I really love it when I can just feel his presence and know that he's right there standing right there with me. As I wake up with
for they love the bread standing in the synagogue and in the corner. they have their reward. But thou, when thy prayers enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which is in secret shall reward thee openly. Let's pray. Thy precious Heavenly Father, we come to you. Lord, anoint me to bring forth thy word and write in the Bible the word of truth. Lord, give us ears, Lord of God, that we can hear, not only hear, but be doers of your word. Help us, Lord of God, to hear the word. And Lord of God, enlighten our minds and our hearts and our lives. That, Lord, if we just do what you say, life would be a whole lot better. Help us, Lord, to grasp it. Help us, Lord Jesus, to walk in it. Help us, Lord, to live according to thy word. And we ask it all in Jesus' name. And the church says,
amen.
Amen. You may be seated if you can. One more time, verse 6, but thou, and this is red letters, Jesus says, but thou, when thy prayers enter to thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. In our lives, everybody, we're so busy. This is not a message of condemnation. This is not a message to make us feel bad, but it's a message to say, hey, I need to do a whole lot more of this. Amen. That I would have more power in my life.
Amen.
And if I put up the title of the message this morning, would be the power of the secret closet. The power of the secret closet that me and you fail to do a lot of times in our lives. And we want to know why so much chaos, so much troubles, so many problems in our lives, because we have failed to do this. Now the Old Testament tells us, and if I go a little fast, then amen to the CD, we don't charge you nothing for it. Amen, we'll get back on Facebook, or amen. But the Old Testament tells us, God divided his people in two categories. Those who sought me, and those who sought me not. When God became angry with Israel over the idolatry, Moses pitched his prayer tent outside of the camp. The scripture says that afterward, in Exodus chapter 33 and verse 7, and it came to pass that everyone which sought the Lord went out into the tabernacle, amen, of the congregation which was without the camp. In the midst of all the idolatry taking place in Israel, there were still people going outside of the camp, praying and seeking God's face. Church, if you want power in your home, in the church, we've got to have to pray.
Amen.
Get this multitude. statute, O Lord, that our God let not man prevail against thee. Verse 12, so the Lord smote the Ethiopians before Asia, and before Judah, and the Ethiopians fled. And Asia and the people that were with him pursued them into Bethor, and the Ethiopians were overthrown, that they could not recover themselves, for they were destroyed before the Lord, and before his host, they carried away very much spoils. When Asa was attacked, he fell on his face and turned to God in prayer, and God answered with victory. Shortly after that triumph, however, Ezra the prophet came to Asa and said, in Second Chronicles chapter 15 and verse 2. Now listen to what he says. And he went out to meet Asa and said unto him, hear ye me, Asa, and all Judah and Benjamin, the Lord is with you while ye be with him. And if ye seek him, he will be found of you. But if ye forsake him, he will forsake you.
Amen.
Now the problem was that again, 2 Chronicles, chapter 15, verse 2. And if you seek him, he will be found of you. But if you forsake him, he will forsake you. In other words, if you stop seeking after God, if you stop yearning after him, and calling on his name, and all you do, he will forsake you. Really, we do the forsaking because, amen, people say, well, I'm right, I'm here. But if you go to the old ways and start cursing and all this stuff and living like hell, that's self like you used to, amen, expect God. Life is precious. Life is short. It's not a guarantee. increasing in the church world. Why is it so? Amen. Singles. Families are falling to pieces. Amen. Lord and God, children running among grandkids. Act like they ain't got no sins. Hello? And we stand there saying, well, we didn't raise them like that. They was raised better than that. And that's true. But yet they have their own choices. They're going to make it life. Israel enjoyed rest when they sought God in prayer. That doesn't mean they didn't have any problems. But because they fell on their face and cried out to God, turning to Him in total dependence. He always delivers them. He gave them order and strength. Why is there so many bound by things in this life? It's because they have forsook God. I believe it's 2 Chronicles chapter 26 and verse 5. And he sought God in the days of Zechariah, who had understanding in the vision of God. And as long as he sought the Lord, God made him to prosper. Verse 15, and he made in Jerusalem engines envisioned by coming in to be on the tower, upon the bulwark, and to shoot arrows with great stones withal, and his name spread far abroad, for he was marvelously held till he was strong. Because Uriah sought God, the Lord strengthened him and brought order to his kingdom.
That's right.
The power of the secret closet comes first of all in having, a secret closet.
Yes.
Hello?
Amen. Amen.
The power of the secret closet comes first of all in having a secret closet. To have a secret closet means simply to be shut up with God anywhere, anytime, in with God, given in quality, chosen time to yearn after Him. Seek Him and call on His name. The habit of daily drawing near to God is meet for every one of us. The reason so many of the children of God today don't have power in their lives is because they pray maybe once a week or whenever they feel like it. Look around, church, from the pulpit to the front door, side door, back door. Where is the power? Come on. Why is it so mean that I'm going to lose my mind, Brother Pruitt? I'm going to lose my mind because it's so much chaos and problems. I must have you prayed. I can't pray. I'm going through 2 months. I'm going to tell you today, you're going to fall on your face and say, God, help me. Amen. My homie can't help you. Brody can't help you. Dying can't help you. Amen. The preacher can't help you. The deacons can't help you. Only Jesus, the Son of the living God. He knows how much spend time with him. He sees how much, amen, you spend more time in front of the television, more time in front of the internet, more time in front of whatever it may be. Amen. It's a message that gets us mad at ourselves and say, Lord, help me.
Yes.
Yes. Keep right. That on fire. Many of us will be honest with ourselves. God, begin to deal with me on this message and say, God, help me.
Yes.
Oh, but we're not going out of time. I talked to the Lord too. That's commendable. That's great. I do. That He wants you to spend quality time with Him.
Right.
Did you hear me? You say, I don't believe that, but the poor man has a reason. Don't have the power in your life. Did you hear me? It ain't just for the preacher, it's for everybody. It's for everybody. He didn't single out just the pastors or the evangelists or missionaries. He said, everyone that believes, he says, these works that I do, you can do greater in my name. Those that believe.
Yeah.
Amen. How many believers we got here? You believe in Jesus?
Yeah.
Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Let's not live a defeated life, but an overcoming life. The habit of daily drawing near to God meant for every one of us. I believe it's, if I'm not mistaken, once again, in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 6. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door. When you go into your closet, don't start praying.
I have problems if we don't shut the door behind us.
That's right.
We need it wide open.
Man.
God.
No.
He said, well, what you mean to be so excited when I'm deaf? God ain't nervous either. When you go into your closet, don't start praying until you shut the door. This means don't talk to your father with a cluttered mind. Shut out all the thoughts that kept you drifting away from him. People said, oh, good, I said that they don't talk to you, but you was looking at me, but your mind was wrong. Things happen. Hello?
But we can't do that with the Lord. Shut out all the thoughts that keep you drifting away from Him. Be awake. You start wasting words, not thinking of something else. But when you come into the presence of the King, the Bible says, He
But he sees in secret. I remember years ago, this preacher, boy, he could quote just about the whole Bible. Said he spent 8 hours a day in prayer, and I'm sitting there thinking, amen, amen, Lord of God, listen, went to several head revivals, and amen, Lord of God, you would think, well, how do these people know that he prays 8 hours a day? Amen. He tooted his own horn. Because you ain't going to tell nobody what you do in secret.
That's right.
Because he said what you do in secret, God will reward you openly.
That's right.
Did you hear me? Well, it just seemed like it's powerless in the daily walk. They wonder why answers do not come, why they don't have victory. It's because they're praying with their closed door wide open. They leave open the door of distractions, and God does not answer half-hearted, innocent, mere prayers. He just don't answer them. Because your heart's not in it.
That's right.
When you go to and you go in to seek your Father in prayer, shut the door so that nothing or no one can enter in. No crowd, no distractions. Shut it literally. Amen. And shut it spiritually and bring every thought unto the captivity to the obedience of Christ. A prayer closet also implies quality time. A life would tell on us if we spend a lot of time with God or we spend no time with God.
Yes.
It tells us.
Yes.
It don't take a rocket scientist to figure out the power of the secret closet. When you shut yourself in with God, there's many promises that God gives us. You say, well, the fruit is just too hard. It ain't hard for you to come to the dinner table and eat, is it? Huh?
Amen.
Ooh, you can't wait. Every Sunday, just my little girl, unless I'm sick. Is it done yet? Is it done yet? She said, well, you be the first one to know if it's done. She said, Pastor, if you cook this before, she said, now don't tell me how to cook. I will tell you how to preach. Don't tell me how to cook. What did you do about the food? I went over to your skin. The secret closet is a place where we come with all of our hearts. Psalms 119 and verse 2 says, blessed are they that keep his testimonies and that seek him with the whole heart. Deuteronomy 4 and 29 says, but if from this thou shalt seek the Lord thy God, thou shalt find him, if thou seek him with all thy heart and with all thy soul. Being in the closet means coming before God for only one purpose, to pour yourself out. It means that everything in you reaches out to God. All your heart and soul, mind and strength. Sometimes you can do this without a word. And all that matters to your Heavenly Father is that you come to Him with all your heart.
Amen.
Prayer will change the circumstances. Prayer will change things. But you've got to shut the door when you're in the closet. It don't mean to leave that closet. It really means prayer habit. It could be your bed, whatever it is. Use for my prayer. It's outside, communion with the birds. Well, that's great, as long as you communion with God.
Amen.
Jesus promised a reward. He promises a lot of rewards, but this is a big one, I think. It's my opinion.
Yes.
It's to have order in your life.
Man.
To have order. That means in your home, in your life, on your job, in church, have order. Jesus says that when we go to our secret closet, shut out all the distractions and open ourselves fully to God, our Father will reward us openly. The Bible says that Jehoshaphat sought the Lord with all of his heart. And because he sought God, he enjoyed 35 years of order in his kingdom.
Amen.
Come on, let me get somewhere. You see, the power of the secret closet is power over all confusions and disorders in your life, your family, your job, your church, whatever it is. The power of the secret closet is power over all confusions, disorder in your life, your family, your job, your church, whatever it may be. Have order.
Is order in your life? Or do you know if you're counting on God or not? Will God be compassionate today? The power of the prayer closet.
Yes.
That can change the situations. That can change your life. To give you that peace and that joy and that happiness. But with failing the absolute thing we got to have. We got to have order in our lives.
Yes.
Did you hear me? Give the Lord a great prayer. Ain't God good?
Yes, he is.
Power of the secret closet. He said, what you do in secret, I will reward you open. And one of the blessings me is to have order in your life.
Yes.
Did you hear me? Don't you want order?
Oh, yeah.
Or do you want chaos?
Order.
Or confusion? You want order. You want the peace of God that you lay your head down at night and sleep. Don't let nothing worry or trouble you. Today is the day of salvation. Let's all stand, every head bowed and every eye closed.